Welcome back, folks. Today we're talking about yet another food additive. They're adding up nowadays, huh? This one goes by the little name of TBHQ. You could pronounce it, but I'd trip over myself in more ways than one. So we'll throw it on the screen for you. Good enough? Good enough. Why might you want to pay attention? Well, fast food giants such as McDonald's have even removed TBHQ from their ingredients. So if big fast food giants like those guys are paying attention, especially those that have inspired the smash hit Super Size Me, maybe you should pay attention too. Let's talk about it. What is it, you might ask? Well, technically it's an antioxidant, which makes it sound very healthy, right? Well, it's synthetically created in a lab, so maybe it has antioxidant-like properties, but that's kind of a no-no in our book. We prefer our antioxidants from blueberries. The synthetic antioxidant acts as a chemical preservative to prevent the onslaught of early oxidation of processed foods. When your food gets oxidized, it spoils. Tastes rotten, doesn't look fresh, doesn't taste fresh. It's all around yuck, as if it isn't already in its prepackaged, delightful form. Anyways, in short, it's a chemical preservative used to prolong the shelf life of these processed foods, which this is best if used by May 2021. So you could pretty much be buried with this in the pyramids and it would still be healthy for you. Good stuff. Where is it as found? As mentioned before, highly processed foods, such as these biscuits. What happened to the good old days where you'd be on a hitch and buggy turning those up in your backyard? Guess nobody's got time for that anymore, huh? Sad state of affairs. Where else is it found? Chicken nuggets, aka Super Size Me, microwaved popcorn, crackers, what is this? Lard, Crisco, vegetable oil, peanut butter cups. Those look pretty tasty. What are they? Highly processed and preserved foods. Yep, good stuff. Why might you want to avoid TBHQ? Well, some say 1 gram of TBHQ can cause nausea, vomiting, sense of suffocation, collapse, and ringing in the ears. That sounds like a good time. They also say ingesting 5 grams of TBHQ can kill. 9 years of research stemming from the state of Michigan showed that TBHQ can interfere with your body's T cells, which hinder immune system function. So TBHQ messing up with your natural T cell function, which is your immunity boost or normal immune function, has actually been shown to promote allergies such as tree nuts, wheat, eggs, and shellfish. Interesting stuff. TBHQ has also been linked to vision disturbances, liver enlargement, child behavior problems, like hyperactivity, those linked with ADHD, and even stomach tumors in laboratory animals. And the Center for Science and the Public Interest lists TBHQ as one of the first food additives and that it should be avoided. TBHQ has also been linked to paralysis in some certain laboratory animals or certain tests, thus begging the question, is this explain the phenomenon that was known as the mannequin challenge? Perhaps we'll never know. Here's an article from dogfoodadvisor.com. Saving good dogs from bad dog food. What is TBHQ and is it safe for your dog? Here we go again. Another controversial and mysterious dog food ingredient. TBHQ, what is it and why is it used in our dog food? TBHQ is an acronym. You guys can say that yourself because I'm not going to slaughter that. A fat preservative added to a dog food to increase its shelf life. But that's not all. TBHQ is also used to stabilize certain explosive compounds to make varnishes, lacquers, and resins. But here's the problem. It has been linked to TBHQ has been found to produce precancerous stomach tumors in laboratory animals, and it can cause damage to a cell's DNA. TBHQ may lead to other types of cancer too. Blah, blah, blah. Well, feeding any dog the same artificial preservative on a daily basis certainly qualifies for what could be called long-term exposure. Well, no crap, Sherlock. With so many safe, natural preservatives out there, why take risk feeding a questionable ingredient like that TBHQ over a lifetime? That's why I refuse to feed our dog Bailey any product containing TBHQ. And until there's conclusive proof that TBHQ is completely safe, I suggest favoring dog foods that do not contain this controversial chemical. Well, there you have it. Bailey has been marked safe from TBHQ. But if it's not good enough for your four-legged friend, why would it be good enough for you, fellow humans? This is the question. Or why would you want to avoid? Well, if you don't want to avoid, you could add some nitrous oxide to these Reese's. But the only place that's gonna get you fast is to the hospital. It's all good, that's this NOS is for. But all in seriousness, if you want to avoid, buy organic, read your labels, or avoid more processed foods. You don't have to have a TV dinner every night. Maybe you should stop popping so much stuff in the microwave and mix up something on your own one of these nights. Anyways, thanks for watching. Make sure to comment below. Or thanks for watching, and remember, this TBHQ is pretty similar to BHA or BHT. So if you want a detailed video explaining that sucker, the little nuances and differences, let us know in the comments below and make sure to hit that like button. Thanks for watching. Guys, as always, thanks for watching. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe if you like what we're doing here, trying to push out more content. And if you have a food group or kind of nasty-ish ingredient that you want us to check out, drop us a comment down below. Thanks for watching.